गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, अ वेरी वार्म वेलकम टू एवरीवन इन द फोर्थ सेशन ऑफ जनरल साइंस लेसन नंबर 1. इन द लास्ट सेशन वी हैव स्टडीड एडाप्टेशन इन डेजर्ट प्लांट्स, प्लांट्स ग्रोइंग इन स्नोई रीजन्स, प्लांट्स फाउंड इन फॉरेस्ट रीजन्स, प्लांट्स फाउंड इन ग्रास लैंड्स एंड एडाप्टेशन इन पार्ट्स ऑफ सम प्लांट्स. लेट अस बिगिन दिस सेशन विद एडाप्टेशन फॉर इंजेशन ऑफ फूड इन plants. Look at the plants on the screen. Most of the plants grow in the soil. They are anchored in the ground and absorb water and essential minerals from the soil. They have chlorophyll in their leaves. They produce their food with these materials by using sunlight. Therefore, these plants are called as autotrophs. The yellow colored plant on the screen is dodder, also called as cuscuta. It is a parasitic plant. This plant has yellow wire-like stems. It is leafless and cannot perform photosynthesis. Therefore, to absorb nutrients from the host plant, this plant has haustorial, means sucking roots. These roots go deep into the conducting vessels of the host plant to absorb water and food. Conducting vessels are the vessels of higher plants that conduct water, mineral salts, and synthesized food substances and provide mechanical support. This is a fungus. It lacks chlorophyll and cannot perform photosynthesis. However, it has root-like fibers to absorb food. It obtains its food from foodstuffs that are rich in starch, such as bhakri and bread. Plants need some minerals for their growth, such as nitrogen, phosphorus, and potassium. Plants that grow in the soil which lacks nitrogen fulfill their need for nitrogen by consuming insects. Adaptations are seen in these plants to attract and capture insects. Such plants are called as insectivorous plants. Plants such as Drosera or sundew, Venus flytrap, pitcher plant, etc. are insectivorous. Similar to the plants, animals also show adaptations. Let us study adaptations seen in the fish. Fish have an outer covering on the skin called as scales and fins on the body. Fins are paired and unpaired expansions of the skin of a fish which are helpful in swimming. Their body tapers, means gradually narrows towards both ends like a spindle. Spindle is a thin pointed rod used for spinning wool into thread by hand. Fish breathe with gills instead of nose. Gills are the paired respiratory organs of fish and some amphibians. Their eyes have transparent eyelids. They have air bladders or swim bladders within the body to help them to float. Air bladder is an air-filled sac. Let us discuss some questions and answers by observing the animals such as frog, duck, and tortoise. Question number 1. Of what use are their legs to these animals? Frog and duck have webbed toes. Webbed toes means having pieces of skin between toes. Their webbed toes help them to swim in water. Whereas tortoises have club-like forelegs and elephantine hindlegs because tortoises are often larger and heavier. Their elephantine hindlegs help them move around and carry the extra weight. Question number 2. What helps frogs to breathe underwater? Frogs breathe through the skin, when they swim in water. They use their skin to absorb oxygen when underwater. But if there is not enough oxygen in the water, they will drown. Question number 3. Of what use are the long hind legs of a frog? In water, the webbed hind legs help the frogs to swim faster, to hunt and escape predators. On land, these legs allow the frog to hop very large distances. Question number 4. Why does not a duck get wet in water? Ducks have a special gland located near their tails called the prin gland. This gland produces an oil which ducks rub over their feathers with their beaks to maintain their waterproof effect. This oil creates a protective barrier that stops feathers from becoming waterlogged. Look at these feet of frog and duck. They have webbed toes. These animals can use their legs as oars. Oar is a long pole that is flat and wide at one end and that we use for moving a small boat through water. Birds like duck and water hen have waxy hair on their body that help the water to flow off. Frogs hide themselves in the grass due to their typical color on the back. They can live on land because they have the ability to breathe through nose and lungs. Frogs have webbed toes, slippery smooth skin, and a triangular head. Also, frogs have the ability to breathe through the skin. These adaptations help frogs to swim through the water. In this session, we have studied adaptation for ingestion of food in plants and adaptation in aquatic animals. In the next session, we will be studying adaptation in forest and grassland animals. Stay home, stay safe. Thank you.